So did you get the correct answer? It is septo-optic dysplasia. So let's look at some of the key findings that make this the best choice. First of all, there's absence of the septum pellucidum. Then there's hypoplasia of the bilateral optic nerve. So in this combination makes septo-optic dysplasia the best choice in this case. Also, some of you have noticed that there is absence of the posterior pituitary bright spot, which is atopically positioned. So there's also a atopic posterior pituitary gland. And in about two-thirds of cases in SOD, the patient has hypothalamic pituitary dysfunction, so patients tend to present with endocrine dysfunction. So that's an important point also for board exam. And then let's look at some of the choices that's not so great for this case, or not as good for this case. First of all, lobar holum present softly. When you look at the absence of septum pellucidum, you should be thinking about some type of midline defect. And one of the major categories that you should be thinking about on board exam is holoprosencephaly. Septo-optic dysplasia is considered as the mildest form of holoprosencephaly by many. And for a holoprosencephaly, remember that is the congenital absence of the division between left and right side of the brain. When that happens, when the division occurs, normally occur from posterior to anterior, and from superior to inferior, and from dorsal to ventral. So the last place you expect to divide is going to be the anterior inferior aspect of the frontal lobe. And in this case, you can clearly see that's divided. So there is no holoprosencephaly. Question B, or the answer B and C, are correct answers, but they are not the best answer in this case. For answer D, Coleman syndrome. Coleman syndrome is a hypogonadotropic hypogonadism associated with congenital hypoplasia or congenital amnesia, absence of the olfactory bulb. On board exam and on real life, the best place to look for is on coronal T2. And this is an example that I borrow from Radiopedia. You can see on the top, there's Coleman syndrome. On the bottom is normal anatomy for your reference. Normally, you should see a nice olfactory groove, and you will see two dots on the coronal view. That's olfactory bulb and olfactory nerve. In the case of Coleman syndrome, you see absence of the olfactory bulb, and you also see the olfactory groove is very shallow. In addition, when you look at the normal anatomy, you should see a nice rectus gyrus, which is straight gyrus, and also medial orbital gyrus that's separated by the olfactory sulcus. In the case of Coleman syndrome, the olfactory sulcus usually is absent or very shallow, and the rectus gyrus and the medial orbital gyri tend to blend as one large broad gyrus. So that's a classic picture for Coleman syndrome. Now, if you have a follow-up question, ask what's the most common associated CNS anomaly for septo-optic dysplasia? And your choices are schizencephaly, rampant cephalosynapsis, aqueductal stenosis, colossal dysgenesis or genesis, or cavern septum pellucidum. Which one should you pick as the most common CNS anomaly for septo-optic dysplasia? The correct answer is answer A, schizencephaly. Up to 50% of cases, SOD has schizencephaly. In this case, you can see there is a closed type or closed lip type schizencephaly, which is a CSF clip that extended from peripheral of the brain to the ventricular surface. And the key here is that it is lined by gray matter or dysplastic gray matter. Compare that to prosencephaly, which is also a CSF clip, usually more expanded, that is not lined by gray matter. Other choices, rampant cephalosynapsis, which is a congenital fusion or absence of division between cerebellar hemispheres. Aqueductal stenosis, colossal dysgenesis, all of them is associated with septo-optic dysplasia, but schizencephaly is the most important one and the most common type CNS anomaly. So that's one point worth remembering for board exam. Cavern septum pellucidum is a normal anatomical variant, so that's not correct answer. Besides, the key finding for holoprosencephaly or septo-optic dysplasia is absence of the septum pellucidum. So choice E is clearly not the right answer. If you have any questions, please let me know. Good luck on your board exam.